buying a house or masjid on a riba based bank. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. ربي سورة لصدري بسي لأمر وحل لبطن الثاني يأكو calling. The brother has an ask a question, like many there are many messages, there are many Islamic institutions that has been built on a riba based, not an Islamic way. So what is the ruling on that one? Well, that does not change the law of Allah. That does not change the fact that any un-Islamic institution, riba based buying of a house and the masjid or Islamic center or anything, is totally prohibited. And that does not change the fact that physical location is a haram. The children who have been studying in the universities and Islamic schools, or if that property is based on riba, that does not mean who is studying in that institution is a haram also, because it is Allah gave them a tawfiq to study Islam and they're coming there. But that particular agreement between the riba based bank, like an interest based bank in America, UK, in Canada, it does not change a fact that it is haram. It is haram. And also the Quran said that especially there is no other matter where the Allah and the Prophet ﷺ mentioned that there is no other matter except the matter of riba, where Allah and the Prophet ﷺ to get ready to have a war with them if somebody involved in the riba. Many scholars have given the rulings that it is not allowed to take it, but it is allowed to give it. It's okay because you're not involved. So I'm going to ask them a question. So this is something like you're selling an alcohol, you're selling a cigarette, but you are not drinking yourself. Does it make a halal or haram by giving somebody else? Of course, it's a very logical answer that becomes a haram. So even somebody, so who are the people being involved in this one? The seller, the buyer, the one who write an agreement, the one who types a paper, the one who signed it, the one who prints it, all falls into the same category of riba. But the only difference is some of them get 100% grade of sin, and some of them get a less percentage of sin, the one who just print the paper. So it's all divided sin. They are getting a sin. And so most institutions, in either it's in a UK or it's in Canada or America or anywhere, but if that institution is based on a riba, that has been an agreement with a non-Islamic bank where they charge an interest monthly, that particular institution, that particular building or the property is a haram. And also this person, let's say for an example, that committee, that group of people who bought that property, they think they are doing something good, they are doing something for Islam, they are doing something very good that will help in the future. If it will help the next generation, this might be in their destiny to learn something, but not in the destiny who has started this whole project. Either it's Islamic center, Islamic school, it's a university, but if that particular physical place is based on something, having an agreement with a non-Islamic mortgage, that mortgage is based on something unknown.